Well, guys, the day has come. Meg and I are finally taking the Jeep on its first off-road adventure. We're going to an off-road park in Glencoe, Oklahoma, and we're going to see what we can do with a stock Rubicon.
Now, I should probably mention that Meg and I are fairly new to the Jeep world. This will be our first time piloting a Jeep of our own, so we'll be taking our time and learning the ropes as we go.
Well, we made it to the trails. Meg and I are fixing to follow my brother and my dad. My brother's Jeep, just so you guys know, is huge. It's not necessarily a Jeep. It's only a Jeep in the way it looks. But my dad has just a regular JK with a small lift and some 35s on it. So we're going to be following them in our stock Jeep and see if we can keep up.
I don't know that we can do that.
How are we going to get out of here?
Well, we'll have to turn around. I don't think so. I think we'll bottom out on that there, and then we definitely won't make it. I don't know if we can go between that rock or not. I don't think so. Don't think so. Well, Meg and I went down in that same canyon for a little while. We had to turn around because we were following my brother in there, and obviously his Jeep is huge. We bottomed out quite a few times, but we turned around and we made it back out. My dad decided to follow that route,
As you can tell, he's currently winching, so he's trying to get out of there.
We don't have the ground clearance for that.
At this point, Meg and I decided to hit the trails on our own for a little while. Taking turns behind the wheel, we tried out smaller obstacles here and there, just seeing what we could get away with in our stock Jeep.
There you go. Perfect. You got it. Stop. Keep going.
This obstacle would prove to be a little tricky for us at the time. And without skid plates underneath, we didn't want to damage anything too badly. So after a couple failed attempts and a little pressure from onlookers, we decided to just venture off into the woods a little deeper.
Nice and easy.
Huh? It's
amazing where that thing will go,
yeah.
Huh?
You did it so much easier than us. Okay. You're gonna see what our angle is. Oh, your dad's recording it too. Holy crap.
Oh, yeah, you got it, baby. Nice and easy. Not even slipping a tire. It's amazing.
25% incline.
A little more speed. Wonderful.
Where'd your dad go?
You got a dip right here. So.
Oh.
He's right here.
That was pretty cool for you to
wonder. Yeah. Pretty awesome.
I was like, I can't see anything. Happening.
We're watching the pitch and roll gauge in here. It got up to 28 degrees. right there. Turn to the left a little. Stop. Turn right. Okay, straighten up. Straighten the wheel. Very good, straight back.
As we got more and more comfortable in the Jeep, we were having fun navigating our way through tougher and tougher obstacles. We were all by ourselves, so we didn't feel rushed, and we really started to enjoy the challenges we faced. A little maneuvering on this one, and we were through.
You ain't got to, girl, you need to put your seatbelt on.
I guess I do.
Wow, that was so steep going down. Jeez. Wow, that was totally
that
different.
That was so steep. It's hard when all you can see is the roof of the car.
Mm-hmm.
What are we even looking at?
What is my driving into?
That'd be nice to have a forward-facing camera. See what's kind of over the hill as you crest it.
Now, if you've made it this far in the video, well, I'm just surprised. Honestly, this is a pretty boring video. I just bought this GoPro and I'm using this trip as an excuse to work on my video skills. Where to put the camera? Different angles? How much to film? I'll get better eventually. Now my storytelling skills, well, that's a different story. I admire the YouTubers that can captivate their audience with not only great film work, but an even better storyline. I've never been good at telling stories, and frankly, my stories aren't usually that interesting. So why even make videos, you might ask? Memories. The older I get, the more my memories start to fade. Stories start to blend together, and eventually the details begin to fade away. Sometimes there's nothing better than looking through old photos and videos, restoring old memories to their rightful place. This is one of those videos, and it won't be the last. As the day went on, I began to feel worse and worse. It's springtime in Oklahoma, and with that comes allergies. And this canyon is covered in cedars. Meg and I eventually made our way home. But before our first trip was even complete, we were already planning for the next one.